India resumes exports of non-basmati white rice to the Philippines and other countries. The world's largest rice exporter will supply Manila with 295,000 tons of non-basmati white rice. New Delhi will also supply the rice variant to Malaysia and Nepal, among others. India banned exports of the rice variant in July and later imposed a 20% tax on parboiled rice cargoes. This to keep local prices low and ensure steady supply in their own country. But New Delhi said it would still consider importation requests from vulnerable countries. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. off to Saudi Arabia to attend the first ASEAN Gulf Cooperation Council summit. Marcos left this morning for Riyadh. In his departure speech, Marcos vowed to advance the country's interests in various fields, such as trade and food security. He will also reaffirm the Philippines' advocacy for a rules-based international order to maintain peace, security, and stability in the region. While in Riyadh, the president will also meet with the Filipino community. Now, Gulf nations are home to an estimated 2.2 million Filipinos working in critical fields.
It gives us, the Philippines, a unique opportunity to advance our priorities in ASEAN under the ASEAN GCC framework, while forging closer cooperation between the two dynamic regional organizations. This summit will serve as an important platform for the Philippines to highlight the need for cooperation in energy and food security, logistics, supply chains, digital information, the free flow of goods, people, and services, as well as the enhancement and protection of the rights, of course, of our overseas workers.
An advocacy group sounds the alarm over the Philippines' rising debt. The country's outstanding payments swelled to a record 14.35 trillion pesos in August, while its debt-to-GDP ratio stood at 61%. The group, Freedom from Debt Coalition, now doubts if government can still achieve even the lower end of its 6-7% growth target for this year, citing slower-than-expected economic growth. Despite the concerns, Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno has insisted that the current debt level is still not a cause for concern. And higher earnings from top Philippine lender and a new terminal project in Indonesia. Let's have the latest in the corporate world from Denise Dinsai. Denise.
Thanks, Stanley. Now, stellar figures from the Bank of the Philippine Islands today. Its net income climbed to 38.6 billion pesos from the January to September period, a record high for its nine-month earnings. BPI points to sustained loan and margin growth, as well as tempered provisions for the stronger financial showing. For the third quarter, the Ayala-led bank's net income stood at 13.5 billion pesos, also its highest quarterly net income in the past decade. Meanwhile, the International Container Terminal Services breaking ground for its new project in Indonesia. The Razon-led firm's new terminal will service East Java and is seen to be operational by September next year. ICTSI previously secured $750 million in loan from Metrobank to help fund its overseas expansion. And finally, Aboitiz Infra Capital's Lima Water transitions to renewable energy. The company recently unveiled its solar panel project at one of its sewage treatment plants in Batangas. Lima Water expects the undertaking to significantly reduce the plant's energy costs while cutting down its carbon emissions annually. The Philippine property sector expected to grow further next year as more workers are set to return to on-site work. Real estate firm Prime says the occupancy rate of local offices is slowly picking up its pre-pandemic levels. But it also admits vacancy rate across the country remains low at just 20%. Despite this, the company is not seeing it as a concern for the industry.
Just this year, around the third quarter, the end of the third quarter, we have right within our pipeline, we have closed a couple of huge deals and transactions that are opening their offices this February and March to prepare for the fully back to office setup. Well, in the next 6 to 12 months, we see that at least in the countryside and key provinces, the growth will continue. We experience around the averaging around the 10% or even less. I'm not really bothered about the 80% occupancy because in Asia, the average is really 80%. It's just that in the Philippines, we got so used to having 90% and up occupancy rate. But 80%, I would say, is a pretty healthy and stable occupancy.
The Philippine Stock Exchange proposes the inclusion of natural disasters as a reason to suspend or close trading in the local bourse. Under the proposal, the PSE will have the discretion to suspend, halt, or cancel trading if there is an emergency such as an earthquake, fire, flood, or terrorist attack, among others, that requires evacuation of PSE employees. The PSE says the practice is being done in other Asian stock markets, like in Singapore and Hong Kong. The stock exchange also said a trading day will be canceled if State Weather Bureau Pagasa issues public storm warning signal number 3 and above in Metro Manila.